Thank you very much. I hope to be able to convince you that it has more than some scientific content. Thank you very much for the invitation to introduce to you Eat Well. I hope the slides can start, or do I have to do that myself?
Just press the button.
Okay. No, there's still not a presentation. Excuse me. There's still not a... Do I have to finish the presentation?
See?
Still.
What about this? No?
No.
The presentation is coming, I think.
Ah. Here I am. Yes? No. I have to do it myself.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Well, Eat Well doesn't come out of the blue. This is the logo of Eat Well. Because eating well is an important societal theme, given the increasing prevalence of obesity in society, which is not only affecting adults, but particularly also children. And it is an important factor in the etiology or the progression of many chronic diseases and cancer. But there is also the problem of malnutrition that is not only limited to developing countries, but also a problem in relation to the acute and chronic diseases, and a particular problem also in our aging population. And we think that by combining the strengths of the different faculties within Maastricht University at both sides of the Maas, and also by strengthening the collaboration with the University Medical Center, that we really can make a difference and a significant scientific contribution to these important health themes. So we hope with our program to contribute to promoting health and disease, the chronic disease burden, by healthy nutrition in different ways. First of all, by conducting distinct interdisciplinary research. But we also see the need to engage ourselves actively in communication and health promotion in society, by further strengthening our international partnerships in science and policy. And we think that this is a theme that will certainly also be able to result in new commercial activities in the area of healthy lifestyle and personalized nutrition. And it's quite obvious that Eat Well was chosen as one of the themes because, as was mentioned before, it fits very well within the strategy of Maastricht University to develop a select range of ambitions, interfaculty programs with a high societal impact. But it also fits very well within the vision and strategy of the Maastricht University Medical Center that wants to focus on integrated care, both within the walls of the hospital, but also outside the hospital, and with a particular focus on lifestyle and prevention. And last but not least, it fits very well within the Dutch top sector policy because healthy nutrition is involved, obviously, very largely within the theme of agro and food. But also, there is one roadmap called specialized nutrition within the top sector life sciences. We also think that Eat Well is a theme that very well links the ambitions of the different parts of our own province. Just think about the Floriade that is currently ongoing and that is really breathing healthy lifestyle and healthy nutrition. And we shouldn't forget that within this theme of Eat Well, we already have a strong position within Europe. Many senior scientists are involved in different ongoing EU projects within the domains of health, food, agriculture, and fisheries. The research institute Nutrim is one of the leading centers within the European Clinical Research Infrastructure Network focusing on nutrition. And Maastricht is also involved in the initiation of a knowledge and innovation community, Food Best, of the European Union. most of the research initially, when you think about healthy nutrition, then you think of research within the Maastricht University Medical Center. And this research is embedded within the Faculty of Health, Medicine and Life Sciences within different multidisciplinary research schools. And only one research school, Nutrim, actually has the name nutrition in its name, but the research fitting within the Eat Well team is certainly not exclusively taking place within this research institute, but also in other of research schools within the Faculty of Health, Medicine and Life Sciences. And what kind of expertise do we offer? Obviously, we have a lot of expertise within nutrition in health and disease. There is a strong collaboration and participation of the various medical disciplines. There's an important expertise in food toxicology, nutritional epidemiology, and health promotion. The type of research that we are doing within the Faculty of Health, Medicine, and Life Sciences is predominantly translational research, biomedical research. So we try to better understand mechanisms of an abnormal metabolism that will affect our health and disease progression, and then we try to find targets for specific nutritional modulation. But we also characterize patient populations and healthy populations very well to find new leads for intervention. And for that, we have a very good infrastructure, which I think is worldwide a distinct infrastructure, to better characterize the subjects and patients. And to give you some idea of recent highlights of research within Nutrim, so we found new nutritional targets and mechanisms in the adipose tissue, not only the white adipose tissue, but also the brown adipose tissue that may be beneficial for health. Nutritional targets in the skeletal muscle to maintain physical functioning and quality of life. But we also elucidated that food can affect the nerve system. Excuse me. But research within Nutrim and the Faculty of Health, Medicine and Life Sciences also clearly has shown specific health effects of nutritional interventions, so more applied research. For instance, health, cardiovascular health effects of plant stanols and steroids, the potential to delay the progression of pre-diabetes to diabetes with diet and exercise intervention, and so on and so on. So this indeed has led to innovations in nutrition and health in the sense that we have a lot of collaborations with small as well as large companies that develop new products and new nutritional strategies. And part of this research is embedded within the Top Institute Food and Nutrition. So you would say, well, this is already quite an achievement. But are we there yet? Do these insights really lead to an improvement of quality of life? And this was evaluated by the end of last year, because also the Dutch government has stimulated innovations in food and nutrition quite a lot in the past decade. And then when you read the report, and particularly the question whether or not quality of life has improved in this strategy, then there is a question mark, because you're not there only by better understanding the biology and by developing new products. We need to know more. And one obvious one is when you think about eating well is the link between biology and behavior. And when we then go back to our Maastricht Health Campus, so the other side of the Maas, then you see that we not only have a strong university medical center, but we also have a faculty of psychology and neurosciences. And they have a lot of knowledge in eating behavior, in interventions, cognitive behavioral interventions to change diet and dietary intake, but also really innovative neuroimaging techniques. And also here, just to give you some flavor of relevant research within the psychology faculty on eating, they have identified, for instance, that obese people are more impulsive than healthy weight people, and that the degree of impulsivity in obese children predicts treatment success. They have highlighted the importance of cognitive therapy for delaying the relapse of getting obesity when you have lost weight. But for instance, they also have identified that a food tax may be indeed a change consumer behavior. So a lot of relevant insights that you can imagine if you combine them, that you can really get a step further. And when you see the infrastructure of the Maastricht Health Campus, and you combine the infrastructure of the Maastricht University Medical Center and this of the Faculty of Psychology and Neuroscience, then I really think that we have a unique setting. There's a unique combination of technology and expertise, which I think is worldwide competing, and which we can use more in a better way by further collaboration to better understand the individual. But there is more, because we have the School of Business and Economics. When you think of healthy nutrition, when you think of eating well, then the consumer perspective is very important. And the School of Business and Economics is has a lot of experience in consumer science, but also marketing and innovation. And last but not least, the Faculty of Law. When developing new products, so-called functional foods, then it's important to know whether or not you can put health and nutrition claims on these products. What about food safety? But also, what about intellectual property rights? So when you hear me, I hope that it's not surprising that it makes sense that maybe when you combine the expertise that we can fill in some gaps. And in a sense, the first step to realize this was by combining this expertise in a master, the so-called Master Health Food Innovation and Management, that started in 2010 and indeed is quite successful. But how to further fill in this research? Well, we started by setting up a steering committee of four persons from the different faculties. Professor Jos Lemming from the School of Business and Economics, Professor Anita Janssen from the Faculty of Psychology and Neurosciences, and Professor Ellen Vos from the Faculty of Law, as well as myself. And then we were saying, okay, there are a lot of opportunities, but who is going to define what opportunity that we should take? And we decided to choose for a bottom-up collaborative research approach to define projects with a maximum duration of 2 years, and that the applicants should be talented as assistant professors or postdocs, because they are the future. If this is an interesting team, then they have to build this team. Obviously, the research proposal should be interdisciplinary, and the collaboration should be at least between two faculties. We were very glad that there was a financial incentive by the Maastricht University Medical Center, because then you really have to offer something to stimulate the people. But we were saying only 50% of the project's cost will be paid by the grant. The other 50% should be done by the research group itself, and that could be 25% in kind, but 25% should be really cash money brought in by the faculty or the school, the research team, or an external partner. And also important was the fact that for the judgment, what proposals should be go through, that there was not only a written judgment, but written proposal, but also an interview. Because we really wanted to have motivated, talented young people that start working on this initiative. But first we realized we have to know each other a little bit better. So we did have a kick-off meeting. And we deliberately did this kick-off meeting in Venlo to show the integration within the province, but also, you know, that everybody is away from his or her home setting. And in addition to short presentations by the different faculties, we also already started workshops. So we had already brainstorms together. And from some of these brainstorms, ultimately, projects were awarded. And then, you know, a nice combination is to sit together, to brainstorm, then to cook together and to eat together. And this indeed resulted when we had a call for projects in 15 applications. 75 scientists were involved in all of the applications. And interestingly, 10 external partners were involved in these applications, which I think for such a first initiative is quite a nice success. But obviously we couldn't award all projects. We were very critical, although we would have loved to award them all, but we didn't have enough money. So we awarded five postdoc projects. And I don't have time to further explain these projects for you. Interestingly, most of them were focusing really on the obesity prevention and management, and there was a strong interest to focus also on the children, so the young people. You can find the awarded projects on our website, the Eat Well website, and here you can see then when you click on the posters, then there's a lot of information on the project. So those of you who are interested, please go to our website. In addition to the five projects, we provided some seeding money to implementation initiatives that we thought were maybe a bit too ambitious, but were very interesting to give a first financial support. And also two of these initiatives very well fit within the Personalized Lifestyle Center that is one of the projects of the Maastricht Health Campus. So like I said, we do have a website, www.umeatwell. Please go to the website, have a look. There's a lot of information on it, of our expertise, our ongoing research, the different facilities. And if you have questions, then you can just contact us. The best is to join forces, so maybe people, we have forgotten people, then join forces, because we then can even eat better. And the idea is, obviously, there was a financial incentive. You start together, but ultimately, we want to prepare better for external money from, for instance, the Dutch top sectors or the European Union program. And then we hope that within some years from now, Maastricht University is not only leading in learning, but also leading in eating. Thank you very much.
We have time for some questions. And of course, you showed us that there's more than just a little bit of research. Actually, if you look at the sector rankings of certain themes, that Maastricht scores really in the world top, particularly in the area of food and also the relation of food and health. And I think it's a very nice initiative to illustrate that. Any questions to Annemie or comments? Well, we're going to eat well later, or there may be also some opportunity for dancing for your health, but there's a question here.
Yeah, Annemie, thanks a lot. It's a nice example of a multidisciplinary approach, and I also like the bottom-up approach that you are chosen for. On the other hand, you could also foresee an even more ambitious approach with big societal questions in the front. If you look at MIT on the $100 laptop project, developing a laptop of $100 for developing countries, or EPFL in Switzerland that wanted to develop the fastest Americans Cup sailing boat. Those are very specific targets, and that is a bit what I missed from your presentation. Is the target, the societal target on eating well, specific enough for this initiative?
Well, I think it is. First of all, we can, you have to be careful, I think, by defining, let's say, as a management, what we think is an important target to focus on as a university, because the scientists, they have to do it themselves. And so we thought, first of all, you want to create enthusiasm for this interdisciplinary approach, which I have to say, at our faculty, there is already a lot of interdisciplinary research, but to also expand this a bit more. And interestingly, when you look at the proposals, that's what I was mentioning, there was apparently there's quite a lot of interest in Maastricht and a lot of expertise to focus particularly on the obesity prevention and the target group of children. If you would have asked me upfront, I maybe wouldn't have chosen this topic. But this is interesting. This is a high societal problem. We can really fill gaps, because if you look at the content of the project, then they are really innovative approaches. And it's an important theme. So in that sense, this is a first project call. Well, now you're challenging me, because this is a first project call financially supported by the Maastricht University Medical Center. You can imagine when people get to know each other, in a second call, you would challenge the people to go for one project supported by the Maastricht University, for instance. But this is the approach we chose, and I feel confident that we will get to the goal that you are aiming for ultimately.
Of course, there's also a lot of money of Maastricht University within the Maastricht University Medical Center, so let's not forget that. But I think the coming together of projects and the next call is very important. I think the role of university is to set, really give a frame, and then you have the sciences put to work, and they come with great ideas, and then you have to see, that's the next step, was also your last slide, how do I again get additional funding for that? And so Andrea can say, she didn't show all projects, MIT has the $100 laptop, we have the, as you know, 500,000 euro hamburger, which goes kind of the other way. It's another project that wasn't mentioned today, where we got a lot of press coverage recently. Anyway, thank you, Annemie.